everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the...
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. Back to throw here. That is caught inside the five. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out. They're able to avoid that there.
Yeah, we talked about complimentary football.
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know, we know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, got the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Let's go.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Over the middle, it's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
They may be snapping a ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep him out of the end zone. Force the incompletion. Force him into going for three and not giving up six.
And that's incomplete. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not looking for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Over the middle here to Coates. That throw good for four. It's second down.
That's it, baby.
They'll drop to throw. And his throw is incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Watch that in. Turn his right. Turn his right. All right, here we go.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Wide open receiver complete. And out of bounds all the way down at the 2-yard line. A gain of 39 that time.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Hurry up, here we go.
Back to throw again. Flush to his right. And he will not get away. He's sacked back around the 3-yard line. Sheldon Rankins able to run him down for a loss of a yard.
On any first and goal, the real estate to work with for the offense is really cut down, and the defense knows it. So they often bring heat and pressure, which they did on this play. Got him down for a loss. Not a big one, but any loss of yardage in this position is tough for an offense. Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. The offense on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and goal. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Saints. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. The 20. 10. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And they'll be looking to start fresh. Just a moment ago, they were backed up, coughed up the football, and then saw it go the other way for 6 points.
I just wonder, partner, sometimes they put such an emphasis on things. And you know, in that situation, as they ran out there, they were told, take care of the football, don't cough it up. And sometimes that's the last thing you hear, and that's exactly what you do.
First down, he'll drop to throw. Going up top. He rifles one that's intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. Past the 20. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Holding defense.
So they obviously declined that. On the NFL scoreboard, an update from Los Angeles. And the Rams have opened it up to lead by a couple of touchdowns now. Josh Dobbs with one touchdown pass. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Cardinals got to go quickly. Hustling to the line.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. And now a first down following that long gain. Over the middle here to Brown. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. First down now, but that clock rolling.
Here we go now.
Back to throw now on first down. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. A good pickup there, a 22. First down now, but that clock rolling.
Here we go.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. That is caught inside the five. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Green, 39.
They'll look to throw again. And that is caught by Brown. Touchdown, John Brown. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
They're on the counter now on first down. And the big boys up front, they're gonna stop him right at the line. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
I think there he had to come off of his primary receiver in a big way, just trying to get it to a secondary guy. Unable to get that play completed.
Check down, but didn't even have enough time to do that. Incomplete.
Here we go now.
He'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Again, he'll drop to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
They'll set up to throw. He finds Coates complete. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. They'll look to throw here. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A great play. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Well, Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythemo Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
I like what they tried to do there. They didn't get a completed pass downfield, but they came off of a momentum play. Big-time gain on the previous snap. Came right back and threw one deep, hoping to catch him on their heels.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
They're going to look to throw. And that is incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Back to throw now on second and 10. That is caught inside the 5. A nice gain of 21 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground, and now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Za'Darius Smith. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they were able to churn some clock. They got the field goal, added onto their lead. But that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game. But we probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive, and he's going to profess that he was happy to get points, and we know that's not true.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
After this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
Looking to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. He'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to take him down and to take us to the two-minute warning. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And this one caught by Coates. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. This offense so far on third down, they've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. They're looking at a third and goal here. They'll drop to throw. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And they will take a knee here. The Cardinals on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third down and 12.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
Back to throw. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. Well, going into the final. Thank you.
Hello, everybody.
Try and start this drive in the air. Brought in by Coates. And the agility got him a few extra before he's taken down right at the 10. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So erase the red zone score. They'll have to dial that one up again.
And you know how difficult it is to strike in the red zone because things are a little bit more condensed. You got to go back to their play chart and see if they can dial up another one.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. And I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. Now back to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Give him a gain of 4. Able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now.
Let's go.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Flushed out right. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead. And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And he will score. Touchdown, Chicago. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And they'll get it all the way out near midfield to the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. A few issues here on the offensive line, apparently. He got sacked 5 times last week. They got to him here in the first quarter.
And I would think that running the ball would be paramount here because it's a different team they're facing, but they watch the film as well. So they'll take many of those same principles and try and apply them in this game to see if they fixed what was wrong with them in the last game.
And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And running with power here. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. But they convert on third with a gain of 22.
Here we go now.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Akeem Hicks in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop him?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And this is caught at the 8. And he'll be out of bounds all the way down at the 6. A good pick up there, 26 yards. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 3 yards is the gain that time, second and goal. Throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Let's go!
They'll set up a throw. Looking right sideline, that's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from it. And he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And he'll be knocked down sideways. The Cardinals on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 4. They'll look to throw. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And good throw here, that's complete. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, but fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. And defensively, maybe an opportunity miss there.
No doubt about it. When that ball's out, all you're thinking about as a defender is, this is our chance to make a huge play. Instead, he's able to recover his own fumble.
And you're
sigh of relief.
Huh? Yeah, usually those wide receiver fumbles, there's open space around for the defense, but not there. He hops right back on it. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
All right, here we go.
He'll look to throw. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. And he's such a talented tight end, just creates nightmarish tight matchups on the other side.
He's so good that when we say tight end,
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field.
All right, here we go.
Back to throw here. He rifles one that's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And they take over. They'll set up shop. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half. Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. Every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. And he takes this thing down deep into Chicago territory. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Again, he'll drop to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown. And now it's second down.
A man's getting a little loose with the football there, right? Interception before, almost had one here. He's got to start taking better care of it.
Yeah, really should have been back-to-back drives with interceptions. He's lucky there. Second down now after the incompletion. Throw here. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
All right, here we go.
They'll set up to throw. His pass caught at the four. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball down.
And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line.
Offside. Defense.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Back to throw now on first down. And the pressure gets to him again.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he's going to go down again.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. They're going to look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big 30-yard play on third. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll look to throw here on first down. His throw caught right around the 6. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. A great. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Looking to throw. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. Just they move, and they know it affects the defense.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. He'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's brought down. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Here we go now. Blue lining. Blue lining.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. It's rare that a receiver of his caliber would drop one pass, but that's now two times he's had his mitts on one and lost it.
Yeah, and I don't think that they're going to lose confidence in him, though, because of the track record. Such a good player, maybe having a bad game, but I think they'll still go to him in a critical spot.
And he is unable to get in. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. They try to get the nose of the football across to no avail, and now it's third and goal. He'll drop to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Getting set to trot out there now. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tummy.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field. I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Back to throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. That one goes for 24 yards.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
I got 83. Here we go now. 319.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
Hurry up, here we go. Green. Over, over, over. Over.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll fall forward to the 29-yard line. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Check, check. The Cardinals on third down. They've been tough to stop. 8 for 10 so far. This will be third and 15. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the...
We're... back inside. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. Now back to throw. Muscling free near the 40. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. 20. Touchdown, Cardinals. A big play there. 81 yards. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it. Get the football to start the game and score.